Just 2 months after Android 14's official release, Nothing OS 2.5, or Nothing's version of Android 14, is now rolling out for the Nothing Phone 2. If you watched my recent review on this phone, you'd know that I really, really enjoyed using this phone. Besides the camera quality not being the best, this was almost the perfect phone for me. So yeah, because of that, I'm super excited for this Nothing OS update. There's a lot of little helpful changes all throughout the OS. And before I take you through them, I'd appreciate it if you guys can subscribe to the channel. It's free and it really helps out a ton in running this channel. Okay, so with that out of the way, let me take you through my favorite changes coming with Nothing OS 2.5. Starting off with the most noticeable changes, this update packs a couple of really attractive new widgets that you can add to your home screen. There's a new pedometer widget for step counting. It's using its own internal system. There's no Google Fit or Fitbit app attached to this, which kind of keeps things clean. You can swipe through for progress monitoring and to see your goals. There's also the new media player widget, which shows what audio you're playing right now. You tap to pause or play, a little swipe to skip or go back, and swipe down for more details. And tapping on this part will take you to whatever source app that you were listening to, whether it be Spotify or your podcast app. Then we also have the new screen time widget, which lets you track your daily screen time to keep your eyes in check. You can set your daily limit by editing the widget, but other than that, it's very bare bones. Functionally, all these widgets aren't a big deal, but I think they look really, really nice. The animations are clean, and Nothing's dot matrix aesthetic is really coming together in terms of visual consistency. On top of that, Nothing OS 2.5 adds a lot of new customization options throughout the OS. Just like Pixel UI's version of Android 14, you get a whole new customization page for the home and lock screens. Changing wallpapers, accent colors, and lock screen shortcuts is a lot more straightforward in one place. Plus, there's a few new shortcut options for the lock screen, so you're not limited to just the camera and the home app anymore. On top of that, there's some new effects for your wallpapers. This is the atmosphere wallpaper effect, which changes your wallpaper into a dynamic one. By using its colors, there's a seamless transition between your lock and home screens. There's also this new glass wallpaper effect, which adds Nothing's signature glass filter to any of your wallpapers. And since some people like me like to keep their home screens really simple, Nothing also added solid color wallpapers and a monochrome color theme in the color theme selection here. Moving on, there's a few new helpful gestures. The double click on the power button by default takes you to the camera, but Nothing is letting us customize that to something else. I'll probably still keep it to the camera app, but this is still super convenient since not everyone uses their camera a ton. There's also a new three-finger swipe gesture to capture screenshots instead of the typical volume and power button combo. And when viewing that screenshot, you'll notice a few more editing options for marking, which is nice considering how limited stock Android screenshot tools are. That's basically it for the updated gestures, but I'm really hoping Nothing adds more here in the upcoming updates, hopefully for things like multitasking or other shortcuts. Next up is glyphs. These glyphs actually have some new updates. So that glyph progress bar that only used to work for Zomato or Uber, yeah, now it works for Google Calendar too, which makes it a lot more useful than it used to be. So if you have a calendar event coming up, the progress bar will start a countdown 5 minutes before the event. Also, the glyph timer now supports time presets, so you don't have to set the duration every single time. And you can also start and stop this without having to unlock your phone. And finally, something kind of cool, when you use NFC, the glyphs will light up for a little bit, which is a nice confirmation indicator. Okay, so outside of the theming stuff and the pretty lights, there's a couple of low-key changes that are worth mentioning. The weather app has been updated with hopefully less bugs. I give them a bit of a pass on this since they made a weather app from scratch and it's been decent from the start, so hoping to only see this improve over time. If you open up the volume controls, you'll see that the ringtone and the notification volumes have been separated, which is great. I also like to have the call ringtone be on blast and keep my notification volume to medium. And if you check out the quick settings, you'll notice a slightly updated look and layout. Also, just swiping through and using the gesture navigations and all that, you'll notice Nothing has been making things a lot more visually consistent, using the dot matrix design a lot more. It's definitely a bit more cohesive than it used to look. Other than that, Nothing claims that the overall UX should be a lot more stable, reliable, and smoother as well. I had no complaints about this part before, but it's a nice touch. Plus, I'm sure the Nothing Phone 2 will benefit from Android 14's new background app optimization, so some of you might experience better battery life as well. I was super satisfied with this phone's battery life, so I probably won't notice it too much. Alright, so those are basically all the changes coming with Nothing OS 2.5 for the Nothing Phone 2. Like I said, I was already satisfied with this phone besides the camera. Any update that brings additional features and improvements is just a cherry on top for me. So yeah, I like this update. Let me know in the comments your thoughts on Nothing OS 2.5, and if you already have it on your Nothing phone, share your experience down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.